So I thought I'd do something a little bit different, and today we're going to be reviewing, reacting to one of OfficerJohn43's videos, Tanker Falls Off Hill, Leads to Hazmat Response. There's a little bit, like, 2 minutes worth of just talking for drama. About, I'm chasing karma. See some things that other people can't see. Yeah, I'm motivated. You can go watch if you want. Yeah, I'm underrated. Watch the imitators look alike.
To the video. Alright, should we get them to start pulling up here? I guess we can try to open this park up again. Okay. So, here, you take the red car, I got the green car. Alright, come pull up here. Alright, that's about good. I don't want you to slide down. Alright, hello. Welcome to High Rock Park. This is the back entrance, our new grand opening entrance. I guess this... It's just a faster way to the cabins, if you may. Also, a bunch of hiking spots. So, do you have your ID on you? I don't need it. You see your driver's license. I just need your ID and then your camping pass, your trip pass. Go ahead and hand those over to me and I'll get you squared away. And, okay, thank you. Go ahead and analyze this. Alright. Alright, here you go. Back. You're good. Welcome to High Rock Park. Please, no, like, I know this is probably common sense. No illegal activity. No going out late at night and doing loud things. You know, keep it peaceful. Stuff like that. You know, I shouldn't have to really warn you. This is just
a cool
it's my job to get you past the checkpoint. And let's open up the gate for you. Welcome in. Let's close this. Alright, is he clear? Is the red car clear? Yes, okay. Alright, let's open up the gate for this red car. Or you can take the gray car. Come on in, red vehicle. Jeez, he got a truck to barely make it up here. I guess these roads really are very steep. We even got a park ranger up there, just making sure everyone gets up there all safe and good. We also got a bunch of hikers up here. Very busy evening for the park, I guess you could say. We have this tanker. I'm gonna go try to help out this tanker real quick. Looks like he's making like dust. I don't know. I'm gonna just help him get up here. Hey. He's backing up away from me. I can barely even see you there. Welcome to High Rock Park. I see you're a part of Gas and Go. I think I was told earlier that like from like another park ranger that we had like a something needing to be fixed with like fuel or like gas, something in like electric.
But they need to be fixed. Why don't you get the small tank of gas or whatever you guys have fuel going up there? But why do you have an entire like truck going up there? That seems excessive.
Oh, I don't know. Something was wrong with like the cabins and stuff like that. I don't know. But they made it my duty to get you up the hill safely. So, I need to see you. One, I need to see your ID, your Gas and Go ID. And then two, we're gonna have to get you a little speed boost, because I know this tanker weighs a lot. I'm sure. We've had a bunch of, like, trucks with, like, RVs and stuff having to come, like with, like, a little bit of a boost. And
that.
Still, if
you're just gonna be cabin breakers, don't need an entire truck to come up the hill. Doesn't make sense. How are you gonna give him that boost? You're gonna hit him with your man bar, dump the gas, make another fire? All of these are going up here now too? That doesn't seem
like that's just how the park is. You know, there's no revamping the roads. So, alright, go ahead and hand that ID over for me. We can get you squared away. We don't have really any cars here. We only have those three.
The park's so busy today. Oh yeah,
never mind.
They don't really have any cars. The park's so busy.
Alright. Station worker here. Alright. So let's go ahead and give you a little bit of speed boost. Try not to go too fast. Alright, I'm gonna signal over to that guy. Go ahead and open the gate. Need to get this tanker in. Alright. You can go whenever you want. I'll just be walking up. Hopefully he gets enough of a boost, but like not too much. This road is very, very bumpy. Oh, I really hope he makes it up. Yeah. Yep, he is very, oh my gosh, no. He's barely making it up.
Okay, so that's how he's gonna attempt to get up. Don't you think you shouldn't be standing right next to him? Like, you're literally next to him as a dirt blows up. And like, if he can barely get up a little bit, that sounds like that doesn't seem
up here. I just put in these extra cones I had away because I had them out for just because I wanted this car. Yo, why are you screaming? Be quiet. It fell. What are you talking about? Oh no. Okay. Oh shoot. All right. Hold on. Jeez. You have to make sure he's okay. Hey, are you alright, sir? I should stay away from this fuel tank. This is probably like a big hazard. Hey, are you okay?
How is this like thing not? He's under the tire. His leg is gonna be shattered. He's probably gonna be in severe pain. The truck just hit a tree. He's on rocks. I feel like this thing's gonna be in flames. This guy's gonna be unconscious. And he doesn't hear the entire truck going down a hill.
Okay, we're gonna go ahead and get medical down here for you. I'm gonna go ahead and call emergency services. I need.
She's just casually calling him, like, on a phone, not like the radio you guys have. I'm gonna call him. Don't tell him. Call him quicker. You guys need to get FD down here so that he maybe you can get a shot at surviving, unless he literally just likes running injuries.
Fire and rescue and sheriffs. I'm gonna say tanker fell. So we're gonna have to get tanker fell. And the location is at High Rock. Alright, don't move. I do need some information though. Is this going to be a hazard? We need to know. This is a fuel tanker. This is not any ordinary crash.
What do you mean is this gonna be a hazard? Your truck on with fuel just fell down the hill. Your truck with fuel just fell down a hill. What do you mean? Hey, is this gonna be a hazard? We need to know. This guy's dying because his leg's under a tire. What do you mean? We need to know if it's gonna be a hazard.
We really need to know. Okay. Just stay patient. We're gonna have to get everybody. Okay.
What do you mean possibly? Possibly it might be a hazard. I'm not sure. You guys should have this entire road closed. Park evacuated. You should have like every single law enforcement officer here ready to help.
Hey, I need my park ranger. Hey. We need to get all these hikers away. Hey, can you go ahead and escort all these hikers away? Like maybe up the mountain more. We don't want anything to happen. We don't want it to explode, you know, things like that. So go ahead and escort them up the mountain. Just make sure they're far enough away. Alright. We got a paramedic. Alright, guys. They gotta do their
paramedic
thing.
Paramedic slowly rolls up. Like, you guys should be, helping this dude. His leg is under a tire of, like, hundreds of thousands of pounds under gas, of gallons of gas. And he's just kind of sitting there, help me. As this guy just stands there, sitting there, doing literally nothing, as this firefighter looks into a wall. This guy should be running over to here. That just seems stupid.
So, hey, we have one injured down here. We have one injured. We also have a fuel tanker that, is definitely a hazard, so we have to be careful of that. We have heavy rescue here, so, yeah, so we have heavy rescue. They're gonna make sure everything's okay. How the heck did it fall? I did not hear any.
Yeah, you didn't hear anything. Well, I'm like, it kind of fell down. I'm surprised you didn't hear it crash into a tree, and all these people surround him. Why don't you help him out of the under the tire? He's under a tire. Of course, we only have one sheriff here, as he actually runs out of his car to go help. And like, you have three state troopers, or not state troopers, patrol for the park. Yeah, you only have just like this car walking around, nothing big. He's walking. He's just casually walking. What? Why?
Anything. Like, I'm so confused. I ran over to my vehicle, and, like, I don't, like, it just happened. I didn't hear it either. So, what happened? Okay, so.
You're asking the wrong guy, honestly. Why is the sheriff asking? Why don't you guys ask, like, any other people who are actually watching? He literally just said, I have no idea what happened. Let's keep watching to see what it says.
We have, like, the fuel tanker was supposed to be going up to the cabin areas. We didn't.
There's your first problem. How is this entire tanker gonna go up to the, how is the entire thing gonna get up to the cabins? This is like a mile drive on horrible roads with a tanker that can barely get up this little hill.
Predict that this road was as steep as it is, so I guess it couldn't make it up and it fell. We tried to give him a tiny bit of a speed boost, but I think he most likely lost control, and that's...
Oh, I mean, like, you're trying to go up a hill. He lost control? How do you lose control? You're in a huge 50-pound, a huge truck going up a hill. How do you lose control? You think he had, like, his 10-2 on his steering wheel going up slowly but surely? At least with, like, maybe a tow truck, and sure he goes up, a smaller vehicle, two small vehicles, three small vehicles. All going up, get the thing. No leaks I see at the moment. He literally has a tanker hitting a tree on rocks. I think his tire should be popped. The gas should have stuck in the punctuation fire. We need to move him. He's on the rocks. Duh. That hurt? Of course it hurts. Why are you asking? Go help EMS. Yeah, they should be helping.
That caused him to fall down here. Again, I was looking at my trunk. I was putting cones away.
Should I be, like, writing a report, maybe? Taking notes? Like, at least, like, note something down so that they know you're doing something.
Well, it happened, so I don't know exactly what happened. There is a park ranger in...
If he doesn't know, why is he giving the report? Why is him, of all people, giving a report to these officers? Like, yeah, I'm not sure, personally. I have no idea. Go ask the other park rangers. They might know.
Him, the red hair. I think he probably saw it. I don't think that truck is up road worthy up a hill. Yeah, I was thinking
that. This lady understands. This truck is not road worthy. Of course it's not. Why would anyone ever think that?
That as well, but, you know, I wanted to trust Gas and Go, because they were the ones who were supposed to come up here. There's no other way to get a tanker like that up higher.
Yeah, ready? You take multiple trucks and you go up. There's plenty of other ways. Slowly, maybe you have a hose go up there. But, like, it's not a roadworthy. At least she understands. Why aren't you locating, like... Oh, yeah, let me call I don't know, maybe law enforcement so they can get their idea. Maybe let's call DOT so that they can pull the truck up. Maybe, I don't know, this is a lawsuit waiting to happen. Times one getting transferred to the hospital currently, I believe. You believe? Like, FD should all be communicating. I think this ambulance is still just sitting here. Hasn't even left. There's still cones, so they can't even drive by. I don't know what their plan is.
Rock. So, I think this is even the safest way. So, yeah, I don't know. I guess I have to talk to the county about maybe getting this road, like, more flat, maybe? I'm not...
If they have the option to make it flatter, why hasn't that been done earlier? I believe at the beginning he said, oh yeah, I don't think this road can possibly be flattened, possibly be paved, upgraded. Oh, now it's leaking. Okay, so maybe we should check that out earlier. Maybe, I don't know, move the truck before now it's leaking on this perfectly nice grass. Silly.
Sure. Leaking? Okay. Oh shoot, okay. I don't know why it's leaking. Did everyone move? Okay.
This guy doesn't have a gas mask, nor does the EMS guy. They should all have gas masks. They need hazmat now.
You know, everyone's away, it's just park rangers and other law enforcement, first responders that are here. I have that park ranger up there moving everyone to a safe distance because I don't know. Maybe we should get some hazmat rescue down here if it is leaking. Should definitely get some hazmat rescue. So guys, apparently
the paramedics find the leak. The paramedics. So usually the black screen means there's time lapse in between. They all just left the truck to be. Like, this gas is going to be leaking down on the road. Now you have a contaminated road, contaminated grass, contaminated vehicles. And this car, I think, moved. Or there's a different one. I'm not sure. But it's like...
Apparently there's like a gas leak and it's like leaking at a very, very small hole. I don't know how they managed to get a hole in the back of the tanker.
Well, you don't...
Maybe it was just a little too...
You don't know how they managed to get a hole in the tanker? It just went down a hill. I'm like, that. Something's got a puncture somewhere. I'm like, the engine's blown up. The brakes are horrible on these trucks. Like, how is this thing not hitting this? The engine should be engulfed in flames. And these people are just hearing it. It's still leaking. He just proved my point. It's still leaking. It's going down the road. It just contaminated this road. This guy's like, oh yeah, we're fine. As this guy just sits down. Wait, no, the ambulance is still here. So the guy hasn't even been transported to the hospital. So I believe he's not even being transported. He's just sitting there with the EMTs. Oh my god.
Rough. I am not sure how the world physics have worked here. Hey, Ranger, you might want to stay back. We're currently waiting for a hazmat rescue, so... You just stay back. Make sure those hikers don't come back. I know they were very, very nosy. But I'm gonna stay.
Hazmat Rescue should have been here as soon as I got the call. I mean, like, Hazmat Rescue should have been the first people on scene. You have a gas tanker that just fell down a hill. It should have been there, like, as soon as you hear about this issue. Oh, there's a gas tanker that just fell down a High Rock Park? Let me go down there right now. Let's try to speed down there so there before FD and EMS, because maybe we're more required for this kind of scene.
Here, making sure everything's okay. Jeez, he's right by the...
This guy has a sharp stick next to a tanker. I mean, like, if I could, I'd zoom in. But, like, that's sharp. He's right next to a tanker with metal that's about to implode and blow up every single person near here as this guy just runs by. If you look really carefully, it says this is like an air tank, but no gas mask. So it's literally doing absolutely nothing. Good work.
He is right by the gas leak. I don't know how they do it, to be honest. Okay, so... Alright, it's been about...
What is the sheriff's plan? So they're just like leaving. They're just getting the
five
left.
5 minutes, and we have the hazmat truck
okay,
on the
so
way
they
here.
Okay, so 5 minutes. 5 minutes to get this one van. What? You're having that van to be there the first persons, like I said before. Yet they're just pulling up now.
Okay, yeah, that siren is...
Does he have a fire extinguisher? He doesn't even have water. He's just extinguishing a fire that doesn't exist because your roleplay failed.
Loud. So I'm not sure what the protocol here is. Since there is a gas leak, I assume there will be some sort of cleaning,
There's a protocol. Now you have people in actual hazmat equipment. These people should all be, like, packed. Why is this guy up here? This guy's running up to the car. What is this guy doing? He's literally just sitting there looking over into the distance. Let's see,
condition,
does he move?
I don't
He's
know.
He's still sitting there.
Both of you
guys. Yes.
Huh? What? You're gonna have to get... Okay. Why?
You were just near a gas leak. Don't question the guy in the bright yellow suit. He's with hazmat. I think he knows what he's doing.
Why? Like, I'm so confused because I think almost... Like, look at that fireman. He's going... extremely close to the gas leak. Yeah, I know I was near the tanker. Yeah, I know. But I'm just pointing it out, even though it's not my business. Yep, I'll go ahead and wash.
I'm like, okay, so now there's a gas mask. This guy should get washed, she should get washed. Everyone at this scene should get washed off. No matter who. I don't care if there was a hikers all the way back there. They should get washed.
Whatever you need me to do. So... Alright, I guess I'm gonna go ahead and have to wash myself. I guess I could just sneak into one of these showers.
Definitely not a bad idea to maybe have fully clothed. Like, at least they should give you, like, maybe, I don't know, a, like, specific shirt that you can put on while you go through the shower. Sounds like a normal shower. That's fine.
Oh, this is not the perfect day to get wet. I'm going in. Okay, yes, sir. Alright, this is not the ideal.
Okay, so we just have cold water. I'm like, I don't see any hose source. I go to these powered off of tanks pre-made. There's a lot of water being wasted, guys.
What are you guys gonna do about the gas leak? It's like, it's...
Great question. I don't know, maybe go patch the hole. Figure out how you can, like conserve this. Like, stop it from leaking.
Like, right there. I hope you guys know that. Might need to Did you enjoy the video?